Hello and welcome. I'm Uday Pratap Singh. You're watching NewsX. Our big focus, India is gearing up for Chandrayaan 2, India's maiden mission to the moon. It will launch at 2:51 a.m. on the 15th of July from the Sriharikota Space Station in Andhra Pradesh. It's ambitious and it's exactly the push India needs to make. Earlier, we had a conversation with chairperson of ISRO. Listen in.
Chandrayaan 2 importance is mainly to go to the moon and soft land on the moon. At the same time, that to carry out the science, that is of the in-situ science. There we can where to do the science in that one. Also, we wanted to go to a place where nobody else have gone. That are the objectives of the Chandrayaan 2 mission.
What are the challenges and features of this yaan?
Challenges is mainly for lander when it is landing, that 15 minutes it will take, and in that one the velocity or the speed of the spacecraft has to be controlled and brought to the zero in a very controlled environment. The propulsion system, sensor system, navigation guidance system, all are to be a new technology. We have to develop new technology indigenously. That is a new challenging task.
Sir, you are going to launch on 15th July. Then this is a major, this is the first technology in the world and first times you will launch.
Now this 15th July we are launching, this is not the first technology because there are already that other countries have gone there. So this is not the first time we are going. But we are going the first time. The landing point is the place where nobody else has gone. That is near South Pole. That is the place.
How much time will it take to go to lunar orbit?
That is the to go to lunar orbit from Earth to lunar, 5 days it will take.
And let's open this up. Surendra Pal Singh, former ISRO scientist, is joining us live on the broadcast. Mr. Singh, thank you for speaking with NewsX on this momentous day. My first question to you, how significant is this mission? If it's successful, what will we achieve, sir?
Yeah, you know, it's very important activity and mission which ISRO is undertaking, as just now it was told by the ISRO chief. You know, when we launch such a complex mission, where launching itself is quite complex, and we are using GSLV Mark III, then a stack of orbiter and lander along with the Pragyan goes into the orbit. It takes almost 5 to 7 days to go to the orbit, and from there when it goes, then you know the overall complex missions which is there, we are dealing with launcher, we are dealing with the satellite, we are raising its orbit, taking it to the lunar orbit, then you know most complex thing besides, I mean we can talk about what are the instruments will be there, what are the experiments will be there, to get into the lunar orbit itself, you know there's a time slot of maybe 2 hours maximum, and in which we should be in lunar orbit. So a precise calculation is needed, precise everything in orbital parameters have to be ascertained, and the thrusters etc. have to be filed properly. Otherwise we land into the three possibilities. It could be go and crash on the moon, it could be a hyperboloid, it could be a paraboloid, all those things are there. In Chandrayaan 1 we perfected, we were the first one to go into the orbit, you know, precisely. And in the first attempt itself. Now, when the you said when its mission is successful, first is it shows our competence of the launcher, which is Mark III, GSLV Mark III. Then it also shows the competence of our tracking network, our scientists who are doing the calculation, etc., our sensors, etc. Because I understand most of the things have been done indigenously. When I was in ISRO, the things were planned at that time itself. Then we have got a large tracking network which was established for Chandrayaan 1, which will be used. NASA tracking networks will be used. There are 14 experiments. And when the Vikram, that is the lander, goes and lands on the near the South Pole, which nobody has gone earlier, the technologies which will be Vikram will be using are about control and guidance are very complex. And also the propulsion which will be using to go in, enter into the orbit and land, that also is a complex phenomena. Assuming everything is very successful, then the 14 experiments, like 8 experiments on the orbiter and a couple of 2 experiments on the Pragyan, and rest of the experiments on the lander, they will show that whether we have got a presence of water, that everybody talks about it. Besides water, you know, there are a lot of experiments are there, which are like a soft X-ray, hard X-ray, also probing the moon's environment. And through this one, we don't have any chemical analysis. Through all these things, we'll be able to find out the characteristics of the minerals which are available on the moon. And that definitely has got a much larger impact on geological as well as moon technology, moon science itself. Then we also have got a TMC, as I understand, terrain mapping camera. So three-dimensional images of the moon will be prepared. And this Vikram as well as the Pragyan. You know, Pragyan in Sanskrit is means more than wisdom. Actually, wisdom is an English name equivalent, but I think it's more than wisdom. So that we see it. And the Pragyan also has got one experiment, which is a laser. So it's not a chemical analysis, but it will break the minerals and rocks and also analyze the materials and minerals. So now overall impact, if you see it, first is it establishes our competence even to going to the moon, landing it there. I mean, later on we can go to the Mars and other places. Second thing is it also establishes our competence in tracking, operating and controlling a complex spacecraft, a stack of three, which have got the three dimensions, three different things. And last thing is that it will give our scientists to analyze data on the moon. And also what I personally feel, it will encourage a lot of youngsters to go for science, because I am sure after Chandrayaan 1, we went to Chandrayaan 2, we went into Mars orbiter, we'll definitely be going to the interplanetary system, etc. And a lot of persons would like to take technology, which space technology. Also, a lot of persons would take interest in the science, geology of moon, etc., which is an important step in the overall scientific domain and so scientific paradigm of the world. And India will definitely going to gain out of it. I wish a great success to the mission, and I am waiting for it when the whole three stacks enter into the lunar orbit, Vikram lands successfully, and then Pragyan conducts its experiments.
Right, and of course, sir, what would you say to those who are questioning India's affordability, though, for such ambitious projects? Some people are saying we're a poor country, we shouldn't indulge in space missions like this. What would be your response to that?
I don't agree with those critics. They are, their vision is very narrow. First is we are developing the technology. Second thing is that infrastructure gets developed, competence gets developed. So those are the outcome of this one. And the data which we get from the moon, that will help the mankind. I mean, globally it will help the persons. When later on, suppose somebody wants to land on the moon, it will help us. How much is it? Not only this, it will also help us to find out the origin of moon, origin of Earth. And not only this, because there are a lot of X-ray experiments which are going to tell us many things about cosmology. So 1,000 crores, in my opinion, is not a large sum. Actually, if you see the complexity of the mission, and we are along with the launcher, the tracking network, etc., we find the majority of it goes in infrastructure itself. So it's not a waste. It will be used successfully in next missions. For Chandrayaan 1 also, the similar criticism came. The infrastructure developed for Chandrayaan 1, we are using it. The technology, the competence developed, the knowledge developed, we are using it. Nobody gives this knowledge. You see, I come from the generation which worked on Aryabhatta, you know. And at that time also, the persons, some comments were there and from very senior politicians. I don't want to talk on those issues. But we started from a humble beginning. Today we are going to land on moon. Don't you think that this journey which has been done, and that all competence built and the knowledge gained and infrastructure built in the country, the industry has come forward, all these, which even for this particular mission, industry has contributed a lot. All those things are positive gains for us. So we can't say that 1,000 crores have gone just like that. It is not so. So, you know, the critics want to understand everything, because they don't know how much the infrastructure has been developed, what is the competence we get, what is the confidence country gets it. You know, a normal person who doesn't understand anything, if it's land successfully, he gets much more confidence that, you know, what, we are a great country. So that sort of confidence and pride can come when we are successful. So I don't think 1,000 crores is much. I don't agree with those critics.
And I have to ask you then, sir, how do we attract the youth to space technology? What do we need to attract the youth also to this sector? And what will we achieve out of this mission? What can we expect from this project?
I divided this answer into two portions. See, one is the competence, the technology developed, the industries developed. They are directly going to feed into the economy. Second thing is, assuming that in a far-fetched idea that we get the helium-3 from there, we get the precious minerals from there, etc., long back, are not that going to feed through the economy? Third thing is, we can say it's a, some sort of a spin-off of all the things. Our scientists get a knowledge, our students will get a knowledge. Are those not worth for it? And all these things will feed to finally to economy. We develop a lot of softwares in this one, we develop a lot of hardwares in this one, which can be used for defense purposes, which can be used for public purposes, and which can be used for ordinary persons thing. These are the things we aim for something, but the spin-offs and the technologies developed are numerous. It's difficult to list all of them together. But I feel that it will add to our economy as and when we are successful in this thing. And everything you cannot weigh that tomorrow itself I will get it. But the industry, which a lot of industries are involved in it, a lot of industries are coming forward to ISRO that they can make a launcher, they can make a satellite, etc. Are they not going to feed to our economy? So, and then applications of this one. So there are lots of applications of this one. So, I think we should see in a wider context on this one and look for a brighter future.
So much, sir, for joining us on NewsX. Appreciate you, Surendra Pal Singh, speaking with us on this important day. Now, remember, Chandrayaan 2, of course, is all set to launch on the 15th of July. NewsX exclusively spoke with one of the team members of the most awaited lunar project. The proud family of Pradeep Chauhan expressed their happiness over their child's greatest and special contribution to the country. NewsX also visited Pradeep's college and had a conversation with one of his professors over there. During the conversation, Pradeep's professor said he's extremely proud of his student and what he's done is actually an inspiration for other students. It's certainly a proud moment for the entire nation.
जिन्होंने चंद्रयान 2 तैयार किया है, आज इंडिया न्यूज़ उनके घर पर पहुंचा है, उनके परिवार की खुशियों को समझने के लिए आइए हम उनसे सीधे मुखातिब होकर उनकी खुशियों को उनकी जुबानी सुनवाते हैं, क्योंकि चंद्रयान 2 बनाने को लेकर हिंदुस्तान में नहीं बल्कि रामपुर के संदीप चौहान की आज चर्चा देश भर में हो रही है और हर कुछ उस पर गर्व कर रहा है। सबसे पहले आप मुझे बताइए, उनके बड़े भाई हैं, जब वो पढ़ते थे, स्कूल जाते थे, कभी सोचा कि मेरा भाई हिंदुस्तान के लिए ऐसा कुछ करेगा जो हिंदुस्तानी नहीं बल्कि दुनिया उन पर गर्व करेगी?
नहीं, ऐसा तो कल्पना नहीं थी कि इसरो का हमने कभी नाम नहीं सुना था कि इसरो में चला जाएगा वो, लेकिन ये था कि वो अच्छा पढ़ाई में बहुत रुचिकर था, पढ़ाई करता रहता था, उसके अलावा कोई उसकी हॉबी नहीं थी, तो ये लगता था कि कोई अच्छा प्रशासनिक अधिकारी बनेगा, ये उम्मीद तो हमने लगा रखी थी, लेकिन जो है वैज्ञानिक बनेगा और उसे बड़ा काम करने का मौका मिलेगा और उसमें सक्सेस मिलेगी, ये हमारे लिए जो है कल्पना नहीं थी उस समय।
और कितनी खुशियाँ हैं सर आपको?
बहुत खुशियाँ हैं, क्योंकि ये उनका बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट में जो है पाँचवा छठा बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट है, इससे पहले वो 100 प्रोजेक्ट ऑलरेडी कर चुका है, तो इसरो में उसकी बहुत महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका है, क्योंकि वो रॉकेट बनाता है, उसका जो है लॉन्चिंग पैड भी बनाता है और उस रॉकेट वहाँ तक पहुँचेगा प्रोजेक्ट लेकर के, तो उतना वो फ्यूलिंग भी करता है, तो ये उसके पास बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट, बहुत महत्वपूर्ण, इसरो की सक्सेस ही की रीड है वो एक तरीके से।
आप मुझे बताओ, आप उनके छोटे भाई हैं, एक छोटे भाई होने के नाते कितनी खुशियां हैं इस वक्त आप अपने भाई को लेकर?
इस समय बहुत ज़्यादा मैं खुशी महसूस कर रहा हूँ, क्योंकि ये एक बहुत बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट है जो जिससे हमारे देश का भी जो है नाम पूरी दुनिया में फेमस हो जाएगा और लोग जो है वैसे ही जो कि हम काफ़ी पिछड़े हुए थे, हिंदुस्तान जो हमारा पिछड़ा हुआ था इस चीज़ में, और अब जो है काफ़ी जो है भारत का नाम जो है ऊपर उठ रहा है। मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि मेरा भाई जो है जुड़ा हुआ है इसरो से, और इतनी महत्वपूर्ण जिम्मेदारी उसे मिली है जिसको वो बहुत अच्छी तरह से निभा रहा। बहुत मतलब मैं प्रसन्न हूँ, खुश हूँ दिल से कि चंद्रयान टू जो है उसने जो है तैयार करा है।
बड़े भाई बहुत खुश हैं और छोटे भाई भी बहुत खुश हैं, लेकिन माँ की क्या खुशियाँ हैं, एक पिता की क्या खुशियाँ हैं, ये भी आपको हम अभी बहुत जल्दी सुनवाने जा रहे हैं। आप मुझे बताइए, आज आपके बेटे को लेकर हर किसी को बड़ा गर्व महसूस हो रहा है और हर कोई खुशियों के मारे पागल हुआ जा रहा है। आपकी ज़ुबान से, आपके एहसास से हम ये समझना चाहते हैं कि आपको कितनी खुशियाँ हो रही हैं अपने बेटे पर।
खुशी का तो कुछ लेवल ही नहीं है, और किस भाषा में अपनी खुशी को जाहिर करें इसके लिए तो कुछ शब्द ही नहीं है। लेकिन ये है कि बहुत खुशी है, बहुत ज़्यादा खुशी है, जिसको महसूस क्या बहुत ज़्यादा महसूस इस समय कर रहे हैं।
जब वो पढ़ने और के लिए स्कूल जाते थे, कॉलेज जाते थे, पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज में पढ़ते थे, कभी आपको लगता था कि वो साइंटिस्ट बनेंगे, एक वैज्ञानिक बनेंगे?
जी नहीं, कभी नहीं लगा। बस ये था, उसकी पढ़ाई में रुचि देखकर, लगन देखकर बस ये लगता था कि कोई ना कोई अधिकारी बनेगा, लेकिन इस लेवल तक पहुँचेगा, अपने देश का नाम करेगा, यानी ये कभी नहीं सोचा था, इस लेवल पर कभी नहीं सोचा था।
एक माँ ने कभी ये नहीं सोचा था कि उनका बेटा ज़मीन पर नहीं बल्कि आसमान पर भी कुछ वो कर दिखाएगा जो कभी कल्पना नहीं कर सकता। रामपुर में किसी ने कल्पना नहीं की होगी जो इनके लाड़ने ने कर दिखाया। आप मुझे बताओ, क्योंकि आप ऊंचा सुनते हैं, अगर मेरी आवाज़ सुन पा रहे हैं, तो आज आपके बेटे को लेकर जो देश गर्व कर रहा है, देश के प्रधानमंत्री से लेकर हर कोई उनका नाम अपनी ज़ुबान पर लगाए हुए है।
हमें खुशी है कि वो वैज्ञानिक बन गया है और इसरो में काम कर रहा है, संतीश सिंह चौहान। इसलिए मेरे परिवार में कोई नहीं है चौहानों में, इसलिए मेरे बहुत खुशी है।
ये अत्यंत हर्ष का विषय है कि हमारे यहाँ के छात्र को इस देश के बिल्कुल महत्वाकांक्षी प्रोजेक्ट में शामिल होने का मौका मिला है। प्रदीप ने यह साबित कर दिया है कि कोई भी छात्र अपनी लगन और मेहनत से किसी भी सफलता के मुकाम को हासिल कर सकता है।
And NewsX has put out every piece of information you need to know about the Chandrayaan 2 on its YouTube channel. Here's a guide on how to access it. Hello and welcome. I'm Uday Pratap Singh. You're watching this special NewsX digital segment. Well, India is, of course, waiting, and the entire world is also with bated breath for the liftoff of Chandrayaan 2 later tonight from the Sriharikota Space Center. In the build-up to that, NewsX is getting you exhaustive coverage of the mega launch. We've, of course, been showing you special interviews, debates on NewsX, but you can track all of it on NewsX YouTube as well. Yes, all you need to do is go to youtube.com, type in NewsX. Our page, of course, will pop up right here. And we have a special playlist compiled for you on Chandrayaan 2. This is how you'll get all our videos on Chandrayaan 2. In fact, this is a mega exclusive which you'll be able to see. The former ISRO Satellite Center Director himself, Mr. Annadurai, is speaking to us on this mega launch. We've also got a very well-known expert who's breaking down all detail of the launch. The former Associate Director of the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center also speaking to us. We also got explainer videos for you, in fact, including why Chandrayaan 2 is important, what India found on the moon in Chandrayaan 1, which we're hoping to build on this time around, what we'll do on the moon, how we'll actually reach the moon, and also, of course, the people, the men and women behind this mission. There are also some other mega debates on, of course, the space race, etc. All that you'll get online. Now, this is how you'll open it up on your iPad, on your laptop, on your desktop computer. But let me also show you, if you're on the move, if you don't have so much time to actually start keying it all on your laptop, well, you can open it up on your mobile as well. Here's NewsX. All you need to go is youtube.com. You probably have an app if you have a smartphone. Open up YouTube, key in NewsX over here, and here pops the playlist on Chandrayaan 2. You can click these videos. Let me first go to this one. This, of course, is the ISRO chief, Mr. Sivan, speaking to NewsX. And you can like the video. You can also subscribe to NewsX's page by clicking the bell icon there. There's the video. It's already started playing on one click, of course. And you can go ahead and get all the facts you need on Chandrayaan 2. Remember, you must be hearing it all over. Chandrayaan, Chandrayaan, Chandrayaan. But if you're confused, what exactly is Chandrayaan? What we hope to achieve and the big debate around it? Well, NewsX, Digital NewsX YouTube is your one-stop shop to get all the information that you will need to be able to tell others then probably of what Chandrayaan 2 is and what all we hope to achieve as a country. Meanwhile, shifting our focus now, Belief Foundation in association with ITV Network and Dr. Ramanbhai Patel Foundation hosted the first edition of the Gandhi Mandela Peace Initiative. In fact, also the Sunday Guardian Foundation was part of the organization for it. The event was attended by many renowned personalities like Anurag Batra, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief of Business World, and Tarina Patel, South African actor, model and producer. Also in attendance was Karthikesh Sharma, founder of ITV Network and founder of the Sunday Guardian Foundation. Listen in to what transpired. Hello and welcome to this special NewsX interview. I'm Uday Pratap Singh and I'm at the Gandhi Mandela Peace Initiative event today in New Delhi. Joining us is one of the people behind this event, key people behind this event, Tarina Patel, founder of the RBP Foundation. Welcome to NewsX. Thank you for speaking with us.
Thank you. It's good to be a part of NewsX.
Tell us something about what drove you to A, set up your foundation, and B, have this event that we're seeing here today.
So what prompted me to start the foundation is after the painful loss of my father. My father was a very celebrated doctor who dedicated over four decades to serving the disadvantaged, to saving lives, working with communities that are disadvantaged and underprivileged, and he dedicated his life selflessly. So in his passing, I thought that I would take the baton on. And what I've done is now I have a tie-up with hospitals in India, and I regularly take doctors from India into parts of Africa. We set up screening camps, health camps, and we just see thousands of patients at my health camps. And all of this is under his name, just to continue the good work that he had begun. An absolute legend in South Africa. Not only was he a doctor, but he built homes, he built families, he believed in empowering, emancipating people, giving them a healthy craft, giving them a healthy living, a healthy livelihood. And really, it's the work that I feel like he's guiding me, and it's the work that I'm continuing in his name. And then today's event, you know, I'm just in such a fortunate position where I'm Indian and I'm African, and these are the two most iconic continents. They're so rich in heritage, they're so rich in culture, in tradition, and I feel blessed that I can call myself an Indian African and an African Indian, and I'm richer for it. So the fact that these two icons come from the two continents that I live in, it's only fitting that I should celebrate them in this manner.
And it's a special year as well. It marks a 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi and the 100th birth anniversary of Nelson Mandela. How important is it for, of course, the India of today, the South Africa of today, but the world of today also, to imbibe the values that Nelson Mandela and Mahatma Gandhi fought for?
Correct. It is it's a beautiful number, the 150 and the 100. So I thought about this a while ago, and I waited for the 100 and 150. So of course it's Mandela's birthday on the 18th of July, in which case it turns into 101. So it's just perfect that it's like a prelude to his next birth year. I think that it's imperative in the world that we live in today, which is so fraught with grief and suffering and violence, discrimination, intolerance and hatred all around, to remember that such beauty has come out of very similar situations. We had Mandela coming out of apartheid. We have Gandhi coming out of, you know, this caste system, coming out of the British invasion of India. And amidst these environments have triumphed these kinds of individuals, which simply shows us that it is possible. And in each and every one of us lies that ability to extend our goodwill to humanity and to, you know, to collectively. In South Africa, we have a term called Ubuntu, which means I am because we are. It's a sense of collectiveness, and it's so beautiful that we could imbibe these kinds of philosophies. And as I was saying on stage, you know, it really depends on each and every one of us to be accountable, to be responsible for making a difference, and to not rely on governments. We don't have to rely on others. It starts with you, it starts with me, it starts with each and every one of us. So in this world that we currently live in, we look to them to instill the values. We look to them as icons to inspire us and to continue to inspire us, because we can do it. You know, we believe in a world that is harmonious. We believe in love. We believe in humanity. So that's where we are.
And there are also, I believe, grand plans to take this Gandhi Mandela Peace Initiative event forward to South Africa, make it more global as well.
So we have great plans in our endeavor to accumulate world peace. It doesn't start with it starts with one step, but there's so much more to it than just one event. So we have great calls to action, which will continue day after day. It's always nice to celebrate, you know, in an iconic event like this, and bring people together and inspire them. But the work doesn't end. This will continue. We will do more events. We will initiate more sort of, you know, big routes on doing good work with all three foundations together. I've partnered with incredible people who fortunately are like-minded. We have the same vision. We all come together with different strengths, and I think together, it's all in the spirit of togetherness, and together we're going to do really amazing things.
Thank you so much for speaking with us, and all the very best for the future.
Thank you.
With the journalist Avinash Uday Pratap Singh in Delhi, NewsX. All right, well, that of course was Tarina Patel there. Let's